Yeah, so equipment-wise, one of the most important safety pieces and comfort pieces is some really good thick gloves. These are welder gloves, which work well if you don't have access to welder gloves. Leather gloves with insulation, not just leather gloves, because the heat goes through that too fast. But because this is handling this metal is hot. So you need a pair of good gloves. A good idea to wear good solid shoes, certainly no open-toed shoes that's hot embers can fall on. Not a bad idea to have a water hose around in case the grass gets dry and catches on fire. Otherwise, just things that you use to handle to process firewood, splitting maul and chainsaw, so you can get the size of stuff that you need to put into the kiln. All right, so we're starting the charcoal making process this morning. We have one style of kiln here behind us that is kind of a medium quantity of charcoal making. There are lots of different styles of charcoal making kilns. The important thing is that they can be sealed up tight to exclude oxygen at the end of the process and to limit oxygen during the burn, or the pyrolysis as we call it. And so the first step in this case is to build a little campfire sort of deal in the middle of this, in the bottom of this kiln, and then we'll put the ring around it and load it full of wood, and then we'll put the top on and fill it as full of wood again, top it off, and then we'll light it. We have this stick here, sometimes we use downspout, to maintain access to the middle of the bottom of the kiln where we had that little campfire built, because we need to be able to reach that with fire to light this off when it's all loaded and ready to go. So this is an important step. If you forget it, it's not the end of the deal. You don't have to redo everything, but this makes it a lot easier.